The Internal Revolution. What is up, Alien Army? I am Oculus, the alien next door, purveyor of esoteric lore. And on this channel, we discuss everything out of this world. So today's topic, we are going to be covering a few different things, but I pieced them together because, you know, I'll be seeing shit the way that I piece it together, and then we connect them nice in a little cohesive platter. So, let's get started. When I am talking about the internal revolution, first I want to start off with the ultimate handbook of the law of attraction, which is the Holy Bible. I personally use this book as a manifestation tool because if you read the Bible and you understand the gist of what they are saying, you see some interesting shit in there, okay? It's just, you know, the archaic definitions might be, they might not compute to a lot of individuals today, but if you truly know how to read the Bible and know what to look for, that shit is a gold mine of information. Anyway, when we are talking about the Bible, now this is the first thing that I saw when I was receiving this information was the fabled story of Adam and Eve. We all know that story. I don't need to get into it. I have another video on that if you so desire to check it out though. So with the story of Adam and Eve, we have, as I see it, the two aspects of mind. Eve being subconscious mind, Adam being conscious mind. As principles of mind, we know, as enlightened seekers, that the two principles of mind, when they come together to form a holy union, that is when you are orchestrating the events of your third dimensional realm experience to your benefit, to your pleasure, to your amazing. When they are not on board, when they are not working together cohesively, shit might hit the fan, okay? So the two aspects of mind want to work together ideally. That is how we would like to function in our fucking day-to-day experience. We want to have everything cohesive and everyone working together pleasantly. The serpent in the Bible is purported to have tempted Eve, subconscious mind, to eat the poisoned...
Not poison, I'm thinking... Snow White.
To eat the forbidden fruit. Now, it was never specified who the serpent was. A lot of motherfuckers say that the serpent represents Satan or the devil or whatever, but it was never specified. If you go to an actual Bible and you look at that passage, it just says the serpent, okay?
So don't be giving my boy Serpent a bad motherfucking name.
We have the serpent in the Bible who beguiled Eve, tempted Eve into eating the forbidden fruit, which was never specified if it was an apple, a pear, an orange. Ain't nobody know, okay? It was the forbidden motherfucking fruit, and that's what we know. Or fruit from the forbidden tree or some shit, okay? I don't remember verbatim, but you know what I'm fucking talking about. The serpent beguiled Eve because the serpent knew that the subconscious mind needed to be transformed, needed to tempt the conscious mind into creating heaven on earth. Because Adam and Eve, if we want to look at them as caricatures in the story, okay, they were people, right? But they were humanoids. And God, the higher source, the higher self, the universe, God, the all, however you want to look at it, created them, but they were separate in a way from God. Because when the serpent tempted Eve to bite into the fruit, therefore allowing Adam to bite into the fruit, the serpent said that nothing bad was going to happen if they ate the fruit. And guess what? Now they ate the fruit, and when they ate the fruit, God said...
It was never stated who exactly he was talking to either.
Well, God done said...
Maybe to the angels, I don't know.
Behold, the man is as one of us, with the ability to see good and evil. And that is what the serpent did. The serpent, representative of change. The serpent, a snake, it sheds its skin, it... Who the fuck was the serpent yesterday? Ain't nobody know. He a different motherfucker now. So transformation, the symbolism of this, if we want to look at Adam and Eve, not just as two caricatures running around fucking buck-ass naked in the Garden of Eden, If we want to look at them simply as principles of mind, the subconscious is the one that needs to change. Hence why the serpent transformation symbol went to Eve, the subconscious mind, and not to Adam. You have to transform the subconscious first. The subconscious is massive compared to the conscious mind. The conscious mind knows logic, knows reasoning. It does know what it wants, but if it is not directing appropriately the subconscious mind, the subconscious is all over the place. And the subconscious beguiled the conscious into eating the fruit, right? So the subconscious has some hypnotic power. That is why they say, like, listen to affirmations when you're falling asleep in the theta state, because that's the realm of the subconscious mind. You're very easily seduced in that state. You can program someone very easily in that state. The serpent transformation knew that to really make a change, to become as a god, behold, the man has become as one of us, as God said to whoever the fuck he said it to. Behold, the transformation of the two aspects of mind. Now, the subconscious took in something and beguiled the conscious mind into it. So the subconscious is the one that is what you want to change if you want a true transformation as the snake intended. You have to shed the old. The subconscious is a huge motherfucking storage device. This is like a computer where you have all these different type of files in your motherfucking computer, and now your computer's running really slow because there's so many files in it. That's the subconscious mind. Meanwhile, the conscious mind is like, you're sitting at the computer, you're like, yo, I'm just trying to run this fucking program, but it's taking forever. What do you gotta do? Are you gonna change the conscious mind and be like banging on the keyboard like, you must work now, motherfucker, I command you? It's like the subconscious as the computer be like,
fuck you.
Because there's too much shit going on in there. So true change, even though the conscious mind is the one who's operating the computer, wants to pull up a file, but all these other files are nonsensical and they're in the way and they're outdated and ain't nobody got time for them. What the individual has to do to change, to get that computer running faster, running in the currency of God consciousness, has to go into the storage, the data bank, the memory base, whatever the fuck you want to call the subconscious mind, and he gotta delete motherfucking files. He gotta transform the files. He gotta run fucking software check to make sure ain't no bugs and shit in the motherfucking files, right? That's what he has to do. He deletes shit. He wipes the hard drive clean. Now the subconscious mind is transformed. It took the forbidden fruit because it can be a little bit fucking scary when you have all these fucking files going on in your fucking hard drive and you're used to them because you're sitting and you're like marinating in the motherfucking files, even though they're not fucking benefiting you. You're still used to them, so it's comfortable. It's not doing something forbidden. So when you have all of these fucking files going on, you're not going to consciously be able to know what the fuck is what in there, right? Because it's a massive fucking storage device, the subconscious mind. It has every shit in there. So what you want to do, here's the way, the serpent representative of change, right? And the change is the union betwixt the subconscious and the conscious mind. So now the representation, the metaphor of change as the snake, the conscious mind has to take that into consideration. In the Garden of Eden, what happened? When God said, thou shalt not touch the forbidden fruit, God said that consciously. It was told to both Adam and Eve, and Adam, being the conscious mind, was like, okay, logic, reason. I'm told I'm not supposed to touch the forbidden fucking tree. I ain't touching the forbidden motherfucking tree. Logic, reason, subconscious mind, Eve. But why can't I touch the forbidden tree? Why can't I eat the fruit born of the forbidden tree? It's like that type of energy. So what happened? The conscious mind direction, even higher self, God consciousness, is not going to be able to direct the subconscious mind without going through first the conscious mind. But the conscious mind has to know how to seduce, how to transform, how to make change in the subconscious mind. And the way to do that is to beguile it. Because the subconscious mind, as a feminine principle, if it doesn't make sense what's being told to it, because remember, subconscious knows no logic. It's like, it's boundless, okay? Whereas the conscious mind is like, it's like driven, focused. The subconscious is like, whoo, 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 whoo.
I don't know if it's doing that. I mean, mine be doing that sometimes. I don't know about you, though.
So, the subconscious mind needs to be seduced in order to transform and have both of these working on board together. These two principles of mind, Eve, Adam, subconscious, conscious. They work together, but not through pure direction. It has to be seduced, and that is the key. You have to beguile it. You have to trick your subconscious mind into questioning, well, why can't you do this? Or, oh, who said you're supposed to do this or you're not supposed to? And that is how the key to change already exists within you, but you have to know how to approach the subconscious mind. The subconscious mind is not going to understand clear direction coming from your higher self going down into the conscious mind. You have to find a way to be like that serpent, to seduce it, to sort of like charm it into doing what the fuck you want it to do. And that is the key. And this is what dictates overall the state of being. Because the state of being, now that the two planes of mind have transformed, they shed the old with that metaphor of the snake, the representation of the snake. The old skin is shed. All of those program files that were in the fucking hard drive are now deleted. And the conscious mind knew how to do it by seducing the subconscious mind. You have to beguile it. If you try to give it direct direction, it might work, but it needs a whole lot of repetition. But if you can find a way to just seduce it and ask the question, well, who says things have to be that way? And then the subconscious, it's like the interest is piqued. It's like, well, I don't know who said it. Because remember, it knows no logic. It's like,
did you say it? Did I say it?
That's how it is. It's more of like this shifting type of wave pattern, whereas like conscious mind, it's also a wave pattern, but it's more steady, it's more driven, it's more focused. So in order to get a response out of the subconscious mind, you have to go in there a little bit sneaky, like the motherfucking snake did, because that's the only way that real transformation is going to occur. So how to know that you have achieved that transformation that I'm speaking about with the metaphor of the serpent is that your state of being, your entire state of being, when your conscious mind and your subconscious mind are on board together, when you have consciously gotten the subconscious to behave, and then now the subconscious is more working for you. When you say, subconscious, what we're going to do now, you seduce it. You say, what if this turns out better than we expected, right? You want to leave it open-ended, because that's how the subconscious likes to play ball, likes to have things open-ended. It doesn't really deal with things that are closed off or boxed in, okay? It likes to expand because your subconscious mind is the one that expands and brings forth that which you wish to see into your experience. When you are in that God consciousness, behold, the man is one of us. Now you live as a God, you walk as a God on earth. You notice that your state of being changes. Now your two aspects of mind, your two major aspects of mind, are working in tandem. They're working in harmony. They're working in congruence. You conduct yourself as a God on earth because you no longer have any type of reaction to your third dimensional plane. You realize that you are imagining it all and you are summoning forth that which you have going on within you. So anything in your 3D reality, you will know that you have transformed, and you might just have transformed in one particular area of your experience, right? You might have transformed amazingly in like your career sector, but there's another sector that is still needs transformation. The key is here, no matter what sector of your experience you want to transform, you will know that you have to go in there, you have to shed the old, but you have to do it in a way that is going to tempt the subconscious mind into wanting to work for you. And that is open-ended questions.
What if it works out better than we expected?
So when you have transformed in whatever aspect you have transformed from to, you will notice that that area, or maybe your entire experience, if you've just had a massive shift, you will notice that you no longer are bothered, you no longer react to outside external influences. You laugh at them. You're like, okay, I don't know how this popped up here, but you know what? We're moving right along. And that's because the conscious mind and the subconscious, remember, they're doing like a little dance in your psyche and the conscious mind, now that the subconscious is working with the conscious mind is like,
I laugh at that. Don't you think that's funny, subconscious? Look how amazing it can be over here.
And then the subconscious is like,
oh, okay, I'm gonna go over here.
That is the type of direction you want to have over your mind. Thoughts, feelings, holy union, holy matrimony, thought plus feeling equals knowing equals God consciousness. And your 3D realm will no longer affect you in any which way. You might laugh at it. You might find that you're on an upward spiral and things are just getting more amazing and more synchronistic and more harmonious, but you're not going to be led astray by like a random negative thought or a random negative emotion, right? Because the two of them are working together. So it's like they're in this relationship, the feminine principle, the masculine principle, Adam and Eve, right? They are essentially united together. So one is not running off over here and the other one gotta chase it. One is not over here and the other one gotta, like, no, there's none of that shit going on. And that's how you can kind of mind fuck yourself, in my opinion, because it's really like you're mind fucking yourself. If you're letting a stray emotion based off of an outside circumstance get to you, or if you're letting a stray thought of an outside circumstance get to you, you are not carrying yourself as God. And it is just a mind fuck because you're in the mind, you're not utilizing the mind to work for you. You're in there and you are not of it, above it in that moment as a God who is source energy embodied in a physical vessel knows. You're either feeling or you're thinking, you're lost in your feelings or you're lost in your thoughts, and that in itself is a mind fuck because knowing has no feeling. Knowing has no thought. It just is. It's pure isness. It's pure unadulterated bliss. And your 3D, anything that presents itself to you ain't gonna affect you. That's how you know you've truly transformed. That's why they say transformation happens from the inside out, because once you transform the inside, that is how your outer realm experience is going to transform in front of your face. You are first it, whatsoever it you want to be in here. And then you see it out there. But if you see something that you do not like out there, you realize too that it came from in here, or it's just residue from a past paradigm or whatever, you don't take it seriously, and you're both aspects of mind, because now they're united in holy matrimony.
They getting along, they homie homes.
Now you, as the God, you're like, subconscious mind, conscious mind, I know what this is. Let's focus on that. It's more of a calm assurance rather than becoming frazzled by an emotion or frazzled by a thought. So that's what I got for you today about transformation and state of being. True change comes from within. I am Oculus, the alien next door. We will chit chat again soon.